Hey everyone, so today we are going to see an example, a counter example I will say, for this theorem. Now what is the theorem? Now when you study matrices, then you usually see a theorem that if you take the product of matrix, then take the inverse, then that is equal to B inverse A inverse. Okay, this is not equal to A inverse B inverse in general. Okay, and similarly if you are studying group theory subject, and if you take any two elements from the group, then you see that AB inverse is nothing but B inverse A inverse, provided the inverse exists. Okay, so I'm assuming the inverse exists. Then this is the theorems you see. This you see in the world of matrices, this you see in the world of group theory. So obviously that means this is not equal to A inverse B inverse. Those who know the concept of abelian group, that means if the set is not commutative. When you say a set is commutative, if your xy is equal to yx for all xy in the set, if that is the scene, then you say it is commutative. But here, if it is commutative, then yes, this is indeed equal to. So if it is non-commutative, then they are not equal. Okay, so if I want to give an example, I should look for a non-commutative group. Well, matrices may, for diagonal matrices or for the scalar matrices, they will come out to be equal, otherwise they need not come out to be equal. Okay, so first let me give you the example from this world and then we'll go to this world. So here let me give an example. Suppose if I take a triangular matrix, just for the simpler calculation, 2 3 0 4, and let me take B as say 7 8 0 2, whatever, then what is A inverse? It is 1 upon determinant, which is 8. You interchange the diagonal and give minus sign to non-diagonal. And what is B inverse? 1 upon determinant, interchange the diagonal, and here you give the minus sign. Fine. Now what is A into B? So first you need to find the product AB, and then you need to find the inverse of the product. So what is my AB? So your AB is nothing but 2 into 7 is 14, 16 plus 6, then 0 and 0, and then 4 2 is 8. So this is nothing but 14, 22, 0, 8. So what is AB inverse? You divide by the determinant, 14 8 is 112. You interchange the diagonal entries and you give the minus sign. Okay, and now what is my A inverse into B inverse? Okay, so if I erase this, what is my A inverse into B inverse? It is 1 by 8 into 1 by 14. So this will come out to be 112, 4 minus 3, 0, 2, multiply by 2, 0, 7 minus 8. Right? So this is 1 upon 112. Fine. What is this product? 4 2 is 8, and this is 0. 8 4 is 32, minus 32 and minus 21. This is 0 and this is 14. So as you can see, this quantity is not equal to this quantity. And therefore, your AB inverse is not equal to A inverse B inverse. If you do B inverse into A inverse, you will get the answer. But yeah, so this is, you can take this as a counter example where AB inverse is not equal to A inverse B inverse. Now let's go to the group theory part. So in the group theory, I have to take a non-abelian group. So you can play with GLNR, or the simplest non-abelian group you can take is S6, set of permutations on triangle. Okay, so this is nothing but E, then you take 1 2 1 3 2 3, and you take 1, 2, 3, and it's inverse 1, 3, 2. Right? And now if you take say sigma as 1, 2 and tau as 1, 2, 3, then what is sigma inverse? It is 1, 2, because this is order 2. And what is tau inverse? It is 1, 3, 2. Right? What is sigma tau? 1, 2 composition with 1, 2, 3. Now here 1 goes to 2, so 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1, start with 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 3, so this is nothing but 2, 3. So what is sigma tau inverse? it is nothing but 2, 3. And now what is sigma inverse into tau inverse? What is sigma inverse? It is 1, 2. What is tau inverse? 1, 3, 2. You start with 1. 1 goes to 3, 3 goes to 3. 3 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1. So no need to write 1. So this is 1, 3. So you can see that sigma inverse tau inverse is 1, 3. Sigma tau inverse is 2, 3. And you can see that these two are not equal. So therefore, AB inverse is not equal to A inverse into B inverse. And that's why, in general, one has the theorem that AB inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. So I hope this example is clear. If anything is not clear in this example, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you.